In the early hours of the 8th of November 2018, the frigate, His Norwegian Majesty's ship Helge Ingstad, and the tanker Sola TS collided in the Hjeltefjord near Bergen. It was a dark and clear night, and it was possible for the vessels to see each other, both visually and by radar. In addition, the area was covered by Fedje Vessel Traffic Services monitoring system. The Norwegian Accident Investigation Board has conducted an extensive investigation, including an observation voyage with Sola TS and Roald Amundsen, a sister ship of Helge Ingstad. This has shown that there were a number of factors that contributed to the accident.
Organisering, ledelse og samarbeid på brua på fregatten var ikke hensiktsmessig. Blant annet foregikk det opplæring av to personer, og vaktsjefen var en ung offiser med begrenset erfaring. En låst situasjonsforståelse førte til at det helhetlige trafikkbildet ikke ble ivaretatt. Tankskipet seilte med deler av dekksbelysningen tent. Det gjorde det vanskelig for mannskapet på fregatten å se lanternene og identifisere det som et fartøy. Sjøtrafikksentralen på Fedje overvåket ikke området tilstrekkelig. Dermed ga de ikke relevant og rettidig informasjon til de involverte fartøyene.
Helge Ingstad notified Fedje VTS of entering the area 1 hour and 23 minutes before the collision. The VTS operator acknowledged, but did not plot the frigate in the monitoring system. The frigate was sailing with the automatic information system in passive mode and was only shown as an unidentified echo on the radar display. At 3 in the morning, Sola TS was getting ready to depart from the Sture terminal. The tanker exhibited navigation lights. As usual, due to the crew who were working on deck, some of the deck lights were also on. 03:45, the officer of the watch, handover, started on board Helge Ingstad. At the same time, Sola TS notified the VTS of its departure from the terminal using the open radio channel. The VTS acknowledged but did not inform vessels in the area of the departure. The two officers discussed the traffic in the fairway and the nature of the illuminated object close to the terminal. They also observed the object on the radar, an AIS, but did not clarify what it was. It was a clear perception of both officers that it was a stationary object near the shore. The officer of the watch led a team of one officer of the watch trainee and 5 enlisted crew, one of whom was also in training. After the watch handover, the team focused on the training and on ensuring own safe passage for the 3 vessels approaching on port in the opposite direction. 3 minutes before the collision, the pilot on Sola TS called the VTS requesting information about the approaching vessel that was neither showing any sign of giving way nor transmitting any AIS data. However, the VTS had not monitored the voyage of Helge Ingstad. On the frigate, the officer of the watch was convinced that the voyage was under control. Little use was therefore made of the radar and AIS to monitor the fairway. The officer of the watch made some course adjustments to port to steer clear of the illuminated object, but he also had to take into account the vessels approaching in the opposite direction.
Når man først har etablert en situasjonsforståelse, så viser forskningen at man uten å være klar over det, lett kan komme til å søke bekreftelse på det man allerede har gjort seg opp en mening om. Etter vår vurdering ville en vaktsjef med lengre fartstid trolig hatt større kapasitet til å fange opp faresignalene og innse tidligere at det kunne være noe galt med egen forståelse av situasjonen. Ingen i brobesetningen oppfattet kollisjonsfaren før det var for sent. Og det det mange ulike årsaker til.
Sola TS tried to establish contact with the unknown vessel by flashing a signal lamp. However, nobody on the bridge of the frigate saw this. The investigation showed that the deck lights on Sola TS reduced the visibility of the signals. After 1.5 minutes, the VTS operator remembered that Helge Ingstad had notified of entering the VTS area earlier that night. He immediately informed the pilot on Sola TS of this.
Helge Ingstad over Sola TS.
Helge Ingstad.
Er det du som kommer her,
da? Ja, det stemmer.
Ja, styr på meg en gang.
Ja, da går du så der med blokkene.
Inga styr på, hvis det er du som kommer her, du har.
Jeg har vært innom et par grad styrkeområder, så burde jeg ha passert, passert plattformen vi har om styrkeområder.
The officer of the watch on Helge Ingstad thought he was communicating with one of the three vessels that were approaching from ahead on the port side. He was still convinced that the illuminated object was stationary and close to the shore, and that it was impossible to pass on starboard side of the object.
Losen kunne sagt klarere at de var tankskipet Sola TS på vei ut fra Sture Terminal. Trafikksentralen kunne også grepe inn og bedt fregatten om å svinge eller stoppe. Det kunne avklart misforståelsen. Grunnen til at det ikke skjedde var at losen var overbevist om at fregatten så at Sola TS var et fartøy I bevegelse, og trafikklederen gikk ut ifra at de to fartøyene ville løse situasjonen seg imellom.
The distance between the two vessels was now approximately 500 meters. The master on Sola TS ordered stop engines. Only now, less than 30 seconds before the collision, did the officer of the watch on Helge Ingstad realize that the illuminated object was in fact moving and that they were on a collision course. At that point in time, it was too late to turn to starboard. The officer of the watch therefore ordered rudder to port, followed by rudder midship, in an attempt to get around the bow of Sola TS. The two vessels collided outside the Sture terminal in the Hjeltefjord at 04:01:15. Based on this investigation, the Accident Investigation Board submits a total of 15 safety recommendations for the purpose of improving safety. Among them, they include the following. The Royal Norwegian Navy should improve its procedures for bridge service and training. Review the career path and clearance process for officers of the watch. Establish systematic teamwork training for bridge crews. And review its use of AIS. The owners of Sola TS should establish safety measures in connection with the use of deck lights and improve its practice relating to corporations on the bridge when vessels are under pilotage. The Norwegian Coastal Administration should improve traffic monitoring and the use of technical aids and improve practice and procedures for traffic information.